Hello, welcome to BioGrade TV. If you are new here, please subscribe and turn on the notification so you don't miss our next video. How Rwanda gained independence. The geographical space currently called Rwanda has been a fertile ground for agriculture for many thousand years. Records show that humans first moved into the space about 10,000 years ago. The earliest inhabitants of this space are known as Twa, a group of pygmy forest hunters and gatherers whose descendants still live in the present-day Rwanda. Much later, early iron settlers got in this same space. They manufactured artifacts, pottery, iron tools, and various kinds of implements. Sometime later, the Bantu people, now known as Hutus, migrated to the same space to settle there. As of the 19th century, the space became centralized and got expanded with more agricultural activities and some more advanced social organizations there. Development continued there until there was an interruption, colonialism, which brought about a different kind of development. Unlike many African regions, the fate of Rwanda was not decided by the 1884 Berlin Conference. It was decided by the 1890 Conference in Brussels, which led the German Empire to colonize Rwanda. The first German to explore East Africa was Count Gustav Adolf von Gotzen. From 1839 to 1894, Gotzen led an expedition to claim the hinterlands of the Tanganyika colony, some part of the territory which was later renamed the United Republic of Tanzania. The German colonialist, on arriving Rwanda in 1897, saw that there was some division between the Tutsi and Hutu people, and they leveraged on the division. In the early years of the arrival, the Germans did not have direct control in the region, so they relied on the indigenous government and ruled through it indirectly. The Germans saw the Tutsi people as the ruling class in Rwanda and favored them over the Hutu people by giving them more opportunities for dominance. At the start of the World War I, Germany invaded Belgium, and the Belgians retaliated in 1916 by invading Rwanda-Urundi, the geographical space currently and separately called Rwanda and Burundi, which the Germans colonized at the time. As a result of the invasion, the League of Nations in 1924 authorized Belgium to administer the colony. The League of Nations was an international diplomatic group that was set up after the World War I to solve disputes between nations in order to avoid an open warfare. The Belgian colonists further encouraged rivalry in Rwanda-Urundi, as a lot of recognition was given to the Tutsi aristocracy. The Tutsi supervised the Hutu in their attacks and had a say over them. The Belgian colonists even went as far as issuing racial identity card defining the people as Hutu, which comprised 85% of the entire population, Tutsi 14% of them, and the Twa the remaining 1%. This clear racial segregation was the bedrock of crisis in the territory. The problem was more in Rwanda than in Urundi. Rwanda was the part of the colony which makes up today's Rwanda. In 1957, Hutu leaders in Rwanda published a Hutu manifesto which prepared many Hutu people for an act of rebellion against racial discrimination. The first violence took place in 1959 when a group of Tutsi political activists in Gitirama beat up Dominique Umboyumutwa, a Hutu who was rumored to be dead after being beaten. This rumor led to the Hutu violence against the Tutsis. This 1959 violence, known as the Wind of Destruction, was so terrible that many Tutsis, including their leader, left Rwanda to neighboring countries. At this time, the Hutu began to gain some influence in the territory. It was also at this time that they began to seek independence. Elections were held in 1960, and Hutu politicians were more victorious. Gregory Kiyimbanda, one of the authors of the Hutu Manifesto, led the provisional government before the independence. Rwanda-Urundi gained independence on the 1st of July 1962, following the victory of the Hutus over the Tutsis. The United Nations tried to ensure that both sides remained a single nation, however, they went their separate ways. Rwanda became Rwanda and Urundi became Burundi. Gregory Kiyibanda, the leader of the provisional government, won the first presidential election in Rwanda. The name of his party was the Party for Hutu Emancipation. On the 25th September 1961, there was a referendum to determine if Rwanda should become a republic or remain a kingdom. Citizens voted more for republic. There were parliamentary elections on the same day, and the first Rwandese republic was declared, with Kiyibanda as prime minister. Dominique Umboni Umuyutwa then became the first president of the transitional government. Did you know? In the 1600s, the Tutsi king Ruganzu Ndori subdued central Rwanda and outlying Hutu areas. In the late 1800s, the space known as Rwanda became a unified state until it became part of German East Africa in 1890. The Belgian forces took over 26 years later. Rwanda has four official languages: English, Kinyarwanda, and Swahili. What have we missed out on this history? Let's know in the comment section. Will it be ridiculous to subscribe to our channel? If no, please like this video and subscribe to our channel.